everybody, it's JQ Crafty. Welcome to Product Focus Friday. I apologize for this being late, but we are doing basic gray today. And I am going to scrap lift. We are scrap lifting Sabridon dot life journal. I think it's Sabridon, Sabridon dot life journal. She's awesome. She's constantly commenting on things. She's got some really good layouts. This is the one I'm gonna scrap lift. I thought it would be a good one. So a lot of other people who are doing May I Scrap Lift You this month, they're actually gonna be scrap lifting her tomorrow. I decided to do her today. I kind of flip-flopped, and I'm gonna do Mayu Kamiko tomorrow, which is everybody else is doing today. So I am doing Sabridon.lifejournal. I think that's how you say it. I'm not sure. She's Italian. because I really liked the cutout circles. I know exactly what paper that is. And I thought I could kind of do the same thing with these triangles. So I'm going to be fussy cutting a lot of triangles. I will not make you watch all of that. But it was National Teal Day, and I've got this awesome picture of me and my son both wearing our teal that day. This is my basic gray. And I don't even think I'll be using any of these banners. We'll see. Maybe I'll tuck one in somewhere. But I thought it would be fun. I might mat the whole layout on this cardstock too. It's like a navy blue cardstock. I thought it would be fun to do the mixed media and stuff on. Maybe I'll gesso this a little bit and then do the mixed media in here, kind of tone this down just a little, and then do the mixed media on here with the triangles. That would be kind of fun. This pattern on pattern. I don't know how well that will look. We'll see. But yeah, and then I decided I would use some salvaged patina, some rustic wilderness, and some faded jeans. Because in a way, that's like, to me, like teal, like broken up into its components. A little dark green, a little blue, and then some turquoise added in, and that makes teal. I mean, does that make sense to anybody? Maybe not. So yeah, that is what I'm going to do. So yeah, let me get this gessoed, and I'm going to start fussy cutting, and then I'll bring you back, and we'll be in fast forward so you don't have to watch all that. Okay, let's get started. Little spoiler alert, I actually accidentally cut out way more than I thought I was going to. But, there I went ahead and I gessoed the paper. So I forgot I have actually, like, very heavy gesso. I don't know how I forget these things. But I started gessoing my paper and I was like, oh yeah, I can't do this thin. But it worked out pretty good. Like, I didn't put a super thick layer on. It worked well, and then it tones down that floral a little bit, and you still get the gist of it. You still get the idea of it. So it worked quite well, actually. So I did that, and then I cut out all of those triangles off camera. Not too many of them, just a couple strips worth from the paper. So I didn't have to cut up too many, which was kind of nice. And punching out these banners, thinking I might even use them as ephemera or pieces in a little while. So you see me patting on my gesso. It is still kind of damp despite doing that and then trimming out all the triangles. So I decided, you know what, let's mat the photo. So I take the backside of that triangle paper and I decide to mat my photo on it and both sides. But I also wanted some of that navy cardstock kind of matting my photo as well. So I cut out a mat so that it's going to mat the photo nicely. And then I put a different wonky layer in between of the triangle pattern paper. I'm going to pop that up in foam because everything's going to be in foam, just like in the inspiration layout. So now I'm deciding, since my gesso was still a little damp and I didn't want to quite start putting mixed media on it, I'm going to go ahead and do my title. So I went into my thickers stash and I found this one set of LA Studio stickers, alphas, and then also a foam thicker. I don't remember if it's from a certain collection or not, but they're both in the tealish aqua color, and decided to put my title just right on my picture and have it say National Wear Teal Day, because that is what this picture was of. And I will stamp 2019 onto the layout later, but I'm just making sure I put National Wear Teal Day down on the photo first. So now the gesso is dry, I'm going to rough up the edges all the way around and get this pattern paper stuck down on this navy blue cardstock. And then we're going to start playing with the mixed media, and we're just going to do the packaging technique and use some packaging and the distress oxides that I showed you earlier and just kind of smoosh in columns of color. And now simply I'm just going to take the triangles that I have kind of that coordinate with each column of color and pop them up on foam. I'm going to actually use the giant mega foam tape roll that I got from Spiegel Mom Scraps. It is awesome. It's super adherent. But I'm also going to do some wet glue just because there's a lot of gesso down, so it's going to be hard for things to stick. I'm not going to make you watch me do all of this. And then one thing I do cut out accidentally is I then cut apart the one banner and tucked some of those things in around the photo. So now I'm just digging in my little leftovers bin I have next to me, one of the four, yes, and seeing what else, if there's anything else that I have. I try to use this leaf, but then I decided it's not really going to work out. I end up dumping the whole bin out because there's a bunch of small little leaves on the bottom that I had die cut out for Confession with Paper Addict layout last month. I had some left over. I had stamped and die cut a label that says So Happy in black, and so I was able to just tuck that right next to my photo. I have this epoxy flare that I got from Spiegel Mom Scraps as a free gift that says a happy day. So I'm going to tuck that in. I had a little chipboard banner, just some random items that I found amongst my leftovers that I'm just going to use up, which is great. It's always good to use up some of that stuff on your desk. And then after that's all said and done, I'm going to grab one of my Rolodate stamps. I believe it's the Heidi Swap one. And just stamp the 2019 kind of tucked under there. And that is it. And this turned out really cute. I really like the way this looks. It's not quite the same, but the inspiration was definitely there from her photo. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time, which should be tomorrow. Bye.